Hey everybody, and welcome to this new guitar lesson. Today we're gonna talk about the Bohemian Rhapsody guitar solo. I'm gonna show you the solo at full speed along with the backing track, then I will play it at a slow speed with the tabs, and then I'll go deeper with the actual lesson and explain it to you guys note for note. Be sure to subscribe to the channel and to activate the notification bell. And now, let's play! Alright, let's learn this solo. First note is this B flat, 8th fret 4th string. Be sure to dive into this note with a slide and with a strong vibrato. What happens next? We have a bending from F to G. A whole step bending. F is on the 10th fret, 3rd string. Then we go like bending, release, pull off. Okay? Next note is this B flat. 11th fret, 2nd string. Or the entire solo is in the key of E flat major. I promise I won't sing anymore. G, 8th fret, 2nd string. And another bending from B flat to C. That's a whole tone bending from B flat to C. So far we were in the 8th position. Now we move to the 13th position. For this melody. C, D, E flat. Frets 13th, 15th, 16th. Be sure to use the vibrato on the C note. Another bending from E flat to F. And then the first run. C, F. Frets 13th and 18th. If you prefer, you could play this note even here. 17th fret, 3rd string, it's the same. But by watching some Brian May videos, I noticed that he tends to play this note here. C, F. G, A flat, B flat. Frets 15, 16, 18 on the first string. And then another bending from B flat to C. So far we have okay? Then the descending run. Let's see what happens. We bend this note, and then we release it from C to B flat. This is typical from the Brian May style. We tend to insert these very small silences between note and note. It's not like this. It's like this. This is 100% Brian May. B flat, A flat, G. When I started learning note for note, and especially when I started transcribing this solo, it was hard because Brian May has a very, very peculiar swing and sense of groove, and I mean it in an extremely positive way. This is probably why I love his playing so much. He seems to float over the BPMs, over the tempo. Hammer on, pull off. I know it sounds weird if it's slowed down, but it makes total sense when you play it at full speed. Again. Now, another classic Brian May solution, which is weird to say, but it's just a major scale. He's a total genius to me because he has the ability to bring something very basic, very predictable, very exercise-alike, like a major scale. But this, in Brian May's hands, becomes music. And let me say, incredible music. This has been the hardest part to transcribe because, as I said before, he has a unique sense of timing. He seems to drag at the beginning of this lick and to rush at the end of it, but anything, it's super musical, it makes sense, it's beautiful sounding. He's just incredible to me. He just repeats twice this scale. This is just an E flat major scale, starting from the fifth, B flat, root, fifth again. We repeat this scale twice, and we just add this bending from B flat to C, fret 18th, first string. Again, he repeats the same melody we played before. This time, spotting in different live videos from Queen, I noticed that he plays this C on the third string, 17th fret. D, E flat, C, D, E flat, C, D, E flat, bending to F. And then the last part. In this moment in the song, there is a key change. F, 10th fret, 3rd string. G, 8th fret, 2nd string. A flat, 9th fret, 2nd string. Now, high F, 13th fret, 1st string. And again, A flat, 13th fret, 3rd string. And then We have this C sharp and another C sharp in the lower octave. The highest C sharp is on the 14th fret, second string. The lowest one is on the 6th fret, 3rd string. And this is how the arguably most iconic rock guitar solo ever ends. Just this C sharp. From a music theory point of view, it's very interesting to notice how Brian May uses the chord tones, or target notes, if you prefer. Okay, I don't want this to be a music theory video, not completely at least, but let's go deeper with this solo. Let's understand why it sounds so good, why it's so incredible and melodic. And of course, the talent, the genius, and the musicality of Brian May are the 80% of it. The other 20% of it, we could call it an incredible use of the target notes all along the chord progression of this solo. Let's see what's happening, musically speaking. First of all, what are chord tones or target notes? And they are the same, the concept is exactly the same. When you have a chord, let's say E flat, which is the first chord of this solo, you have to know the notes that made this chord. In this case, our E flat is the root, we have G, the major third, and B flat, the fifth. When you have this information for any chord of the entire progression, this is when you could start really using this target notes concept to make music. That's the goal, isn't it? So let's try to understand the way Brian May approached this chord progression, and this is incredible to me, guys. First chord, E flat. As I just said, root, E flat, major third, G, fifth is B flat. He plays a B flat, a strong vibrato. Without the bending, those are the notes. B flat, target notes. G, target notes, is the major third of E flat. F, passing tone. Passing tone means a note which is in between two chord tones, or target notes, if you prefer. E flat, root of this chord. Next chord is D over B flat major. We can say this is a B flat major. And he plays the root, B flat. G, passing tone. This C happens in the exact moment in which the harmony goes in C minor. So again, is the root of the chord. The melody. C, D, E flat. The target notes of C minor are C, root, E flat, minor third, and G, fifth. He plays two target notes out of three. C, D, passing tone, E flat, chord tone. F, this F arises in the exact moment again, which the chord is F minor. Then the little run. Again, C, fifth of F minor, F, root of F minor, G, passing tone, A flat, minor third of F minor, B flat, passing tone, then the chord is B flat now. This is the moment in which Brian May plays this descending run. Let's focus on the fact that he starts and ends this very run using the same note, B flat, which is the root of the chord playing in that very moment. Now we have another spin with this chord progression, E flat. He plays this E flat major scale starting from the B flat, which is the fifth. We have chord tone again, chord tone. He plays the same run over this D over B flat major chord, which is a good idea because, you know, over the E flat major, this is the fifth. But over this chord, this is the root. So, this is why it's so musical and melodic. Last note, bending from B flat to C, and guess what happens now? Yes. The chord is C minor. He now repeats the melody. Same notes, same ideas as before. Root. F. And then we go to the ending, to the key change of the song. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this lesson interesting and inspiring. I think this is going to be the first of many lessons about Brian May's solos because, let's say it, he's my favorite guitar player ever, and basically he's the reason I started playing the guitar, so I owe him a lot. And of course I want to share with you guys his music. If there is a guitar solo you want me to cover in one of the next lessons, just let me know in the comment section below. Thanks again, I am Riccardo Giorgi and I'll see you in the next lesson. Bye!